Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Eloise Collection, four complete Eloise tales. Eloise, Eloise in Paris, Eloise at Christmastime, and Eloise in Moscow, by Kay Thompson, with drawings by Hilary Knight. Read by Bernadette Peters. Eloise, a book for precocious grown-ups about a little girl who lives at the Plaza Hotel.
I am Eloise. I am six. I am a city child. I live at the Plaza. There is a lobby which is enormously large with marble pillars and ladies in it, and a revolving door with papier on it. I spend an awful lot of time in the lobby. For instance, every day I have to go to the desk clerk and see what's happening there. Then I stop by the mail desk to see if they have any stamps. Then I go to the house phones and make several calls to see if anybody's in. The bell captain knows who I am. If there is a lot of luggage trying to get in the elevator and these people are all in a crowd and smoking and from out of town or something, I edge into the middle of it and lose my escape key. I am a nuisance in the lobby. Mr. Salamone said so. He is the manager. I always say, "Good morning, Mr. Salamone." And he always says, "Good morning, Eloise." My mother knows the owner. I live on the top floor. Of course, I am apt to be on any floor at any time. And if I want to go anywhere, I simply take the elevator. For instance, if I happen to be on the second floor, I just press that button until it comes up. And as soon as that door is open, I get in and say, "Fifth floor, please." And when those doors clank shut, we ride up and I get out on the fifth floor. And as soon as that elevator is out of sight, I skibble up those stairs to the eighth floor. And then I press that button. And when that same elevator comes up, and as soon as that door is open, I get in and say, "15th floor, please." And then when those doors clank shut, we ride up, and I get out on the 15th floor, and as soon as that elevator is out of sight, I skibble down to the 12th floor and press that button, and when that same elevator comes up and those doors open, I say, "The lobby, please." And then those doors clank shut, and we ride down without saying absolutely one word. And then I get into the next elevator and go all the way up. Then I get off at the top floor and look in the mirror at me, Eloise. I live down at the end of the hall. Sometimes I take two sticks and skitter them along the walls, and when I run down the hall, I slump my feet against the woodwork, which is very good for scuffing and noise. Sometimes I slump my skates if I want to make a really loud and terrible racket. We have a buzzer on our front door. I always lean on it. That's how Nanny knows it's me, Eloise. Nanny is my nurse. She wears tissue paper in her dress, and you can hear it. She is English and has eight hairpins made out of bones. She says that's all she needs in this life, for Lord's sake. Nanny says she would rather I didn't talk all the time. She always says everything three times, like Eloise, "You can't." Sometimes I hit her on the ankle with a tassel. She is my mostly companion. I have my own room. It has a coat rack which is as large as me. I have a dog that looks like a cat. His name is Weenie. Sometimes I put sunglasses on him. Then I have to scratch his back with a wire hanger. I have a turtle. His name is Skipperdy. He eats raisins and wears sneakers. The Plaza is the only hotel in New York that will allow you to have a turtle. Skipper D and me, we always know it's morning because Weenie breathes in our face and kisses us. The absolutely first thing I have to do is braid Skipper D's ears. Otherwise, he gets cross and develops a rash. Nanny gets up feeling tired, and puts on her kimono and skibbles over to slam those windows down shut so that we don't freeze. Then she stretches her muscles and feels fresh. Nanny yawns out loud. Then I pick up the telephone and call room service. Ugh, I absolutely love room service. They always know it's me. And they say, "Yes, Eloise." And I always say, "Hello, this is me, Eloise. And would you kindly send one roast beef bone, one raisin, and 7 spoons to the top floor and charge it, please? Thank you very much." Then I hang up and look at the ceiling for a while and think of a way to get a present. I usually yawn out loud several times. Then Nanny gives the signal, and Weenie and Skipper D and me, we skibble out of bed as fast as everly we can, and Nanny wraps us in our robe and holds us tight, and I pat her on her bato, which is large. Then we have to do our morning duties and laugh and sing. London from bottom to top is up. The keeper in the shop is up. And even Mrs. Mop is up. Oh, what a lovely morning. In Trafalgar Square, the bulb is up. In Piccadilly, the nip is up. In Covent Garden, the clip is up. Oh, what a lovely morning. We're up and we've got to be jolly clean. From head to toe and in between. Zup, good morning and hiya been. Oh, what a lovely morning. The Royal Navy is up. Buckingham Palace is up. And even the BBC is up. Oh, what a lovely, oh, what a lovely, oh, what a lovely morning. Ew, I just love Nanny, I absolutely do. While I'm brushing my teeth, there is this pigeon who is always hanging around our bathroom window and he does absolutely nothing but coo. He is fat and grizzly, and I holler at him, and he flies over to the Sherry Netherland for a while to see what they're up to. Weenie and me weigh 36. Nanny weighs 18 stones. Skipper D weighs absolutely nothing at all unless he has his sneakers on. Then, of course, he weighs 1/2. Then Nanny puts on her corset, which is enormously large, but which is very good for her back. Kleenex makes a very good hat. When we are clean, we skibble in our scuffs to the kitchen, and there is Renee with the room service. Renee always says, "Bonjour, Eloise, voici votre petit déjeuner." Nanny always says, my, doesn't that look good? And I always say, "Bonjour, Renee, merci, and charge it, please." Nanny has Irish bacon, which reminds her of her brother. You have to eat oatmeal or you'll dry up. Anybody knows that. Nanny likes her coffee hot. An egg cup makes a very good hat. I have 2 dolls, which is enough. Their names are Sabine and Sailor. Sabine is a rag doll, and she has absolutely no face at all, partially because she came from Jamaica by Air Express. Otherwise, she has shoe button eyes and 2 right legs. She is rather unusual. sailor is a very large dog.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.